Smart Cerebrum Private Limited is a team of academicians and experts who are into education field since decades. We are proud to be associated with more than 1,500 institutions across the country. We are into academic consultation, teacher training, student training, communicative English, Vedic mathematics, subject-specific training, content development, and many more. Smart Learning is a service-oriented social initiative from Smart Cerebrum Private Limited, wherein subject-specific experts will be conducting online sessions for the student community at large. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel for constant updates about upcoming sessions and topics. All the sessions will be related to the syllabus and curriculum. We welcome Bhartima and all our viewers for today's session. As this session is for grade 9 social science, all about date and time, part 2. Please type the queries on our YouTube channel. We welcome you, ma'am. Ma'am, please unmute your microphone. Yes, ma'am.
Welcome all of you. Welcome all the viewers. Thank you, SmartC. Yes, children, welcome back to the geography by Miss Bharti. Children, here I have a statement to make. You all must have been very commonly listening to a statement, sun rises in the east. Somewhere right from your class 3, your English teacher probably might have used this statement. And even in your higher classes, up to class 9, when the teacher teaches English tenses, they must have used this sentence, sun rises in the east. Yes, grammatically, as far as English is concerned, the statement is grammatically very correct. But I would say, as a geography teacher, the statement is wrong. You wonder why? All of you know that in the solar system, sun is stationary. Sun remains at the center of the solar system, and all the other planets, they revolve in a particular orbit and they rotate also. So rotation and revolution is there with the planets, only with the planets, and sun remains stationary. So, when sun remains stationary, how do we say that sun rises in the east? Sun never rises. We need to understand that only grammatically the sentence was being used. But geographically, it is only that the earth moves, the earth rotates. The movements of the earth are of two types again. One is rotation, the other is revolution. So, first we will understand what is rotation. Rotation, to rotate, a very simple word. If you see a globe, children, all of you can see this globe. This is the globe, and see, if I show this, now look at this, because this globe is a replica, almost a replica again. It's not the exact replica, it's almost a replica of the earth. It is spherical in shape for all practical reasons. And we need some starting point, we need some ending point. So for that sake, I have taken this part of the globe where you all can see this black line. Now tell me which one is east and which one is west. So this side is called eastern side and this side is called western side. Children, don't be confused because the image may be a mirror image. So first, what should come, supposing we start from this North America and South America, they should come first, then Australia, then it is once again the North America and South America. Hope my map is, my globe is very clear to all of you and you are all able to see. So now this is the direction of Earth's rotation. Now, suppose in North America and South America you are able to see, then what should be you be able to see? Then it should be Africa. Then again, it should be India, Australia, all these islands in between, Sumatra, Java, Brownie, Indonesian islands. And then once again, North America and South America. This is the correct way. This is the exact way of how Earth rotates. Remember, sun never rises in the east. Always, Earth rotates from east to west. Yes. Now, let us look into the date and time. Already, I have told you that how many longitudes in my previous class, I told you about the number of longitudes. Now, what is this use? What is the use of all these imaginary lines? First, we will talk about the use of longitudes. Already, I told you that the longitudes, they run vertically from North Pole to South Pole. They join the North Pole and South Pole. On the globe, you can see that they all meet, all these longitudes, they converge at North Pole and again converge at South Pole, right? And these lines are called longitudes after every 1 degree. After every 1 degree, because North Pole and South Pole are only points. So, what is the angle of a point? 360 degrees. So, after every 1 degree, one imaginary line has been drawn. So, on the whole, how many longitudes are there? 360 longitudes. On the whole, there are 360 longitudes, and the time calculated, it is also observed that the time taken for the sun rays to fall, the sun rays to fall from the time taken for the sun rays to reach from one longitude to other is 4 minutes. It takes 4 minutes, and if that with the help of that calculation, the time taken is 4 minutes. Now, if you see the total number of longitudes, as already I have stressed that it is 316 number of longitudes that we have drawn, total time taken to complete all the longitudes. So, for all the longitudes to be covered, the time taken is, again, just a simple calculation, 4 minutes into 360, which makes it into 1440 minutes. And if that minutes are again converted into, divided by 60, we will get hours, which is 24 hours. That is how one complete rotation finishes only after 24 hours. It means in 124 hours, we will have one day and one night. Why this is day? Now, children, you are able only to see one part of the globe where you can see only Australia. Supposing you just imagine that you are sun and this is earth. Now, when the earth is rotating, now that you have seen Australia, then slowly Africa, isn't it? Then slowly you have seen Africa, then you have seen South America, and it is only, this is the Pacific Ocean, the entire Pacific Ocean. There is almost no continent here. Right? Then again, slowly, Australia will come. It means by this time, when Australia was here, it means when Australia was, you were exactly watching Australia, the other half, if I have turned the globe like this, the other half was having night. It means the sun rays cannot fall on that side, and that part of the world, we call it as it is having its night. So only where the sun rays fall, that region, we call it as day. So for the completion of one day, it means one whole day with sunlight and one whole night with the darker part, the total time taken that we have seen with 360 degrees or 60 longitude with 4 minutes calculated, it comes up to 24 hours. Now, No. How are now these 24 hours per day? Children, always there was a question. Why? What are these days in a month? How? What is the logic behind distributing these days in a month? When we know that there are, it is also calculated with very, very minute calculations. It has been found out that for time taken for one complete revolution, supposing this is sun and supposing this is the orbit, so time taken for completing one revolution from year to year, it is 365. We call it as 1 year. So that is what is called revolution, and that is when 365 days we have per year. How is that we have distributed? Why do some months have lesser number of days, and why do some months have more number of days? And why is it that February has got 28 days and sometimes it is 29 days? Why? What is this leap year? Many times, have you ever heard, children, a simple question, have you ever heard a child with his birthday on October 32nd? Must be not. February 38th? Surely it cannot be, because there is no such calendar, nowhere in the world rather, there is no such calendar which has got these dates. February 30th will not be there at any cost. October 32 also will not be there. What is the reason? All these calendar, if now presently we are following the calendar system which is called Gregorian calendar. Previously, that is nearly 800 BC, we were all following Roman calendar. And as all of you know, the names, the months, the names of these months also, they are all derived from the Roman names. They all relate to the Roman names, and everybody was following Roman calendar. Here is a small story about this Roman calendar. Children, Rome, their staple food was wheat. Staple food was bread, and bread was made from wheat and barley. And for them, agriculture was very important. There were only 10 months starting from March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, and December. Their calculation was only from year to year, from November to December, March to December. They missed out, they never had this January or February. They were not there in the beginning. They only calculated that we have 10 months. What is this 10 months? Okay, with all these 10 months, now, how many days would be there? 10 months were equally distributed. Again, Romans, they had many, many omens. They believed in good omen, bad omen, lucky, unlucky. They believed in all these things. And they always felt that either a month should have 31 days. They always felt that 2, 4, 6, 8. These were all unlucky numbers for them. They never wanted to have these numbers in the calendar. And they only had 10 months. Only 10 months they would do agriculture. And agriculture was possible during these 10 months. And the rest 2 months, they were not, nobody bothered to give them names also. So in the beginning, there were no names called, there were no months also called January and February. So see, they have come late, but they have become latest. They are at the top, though they have come late. Very lately, somewhere in 50 BC, these 2 months were later introduced. They were added, and that too, see the luck, they were added in the beginning, not at the end somewhere. Generally, when we add, we somewhere put them at the bottom, but they have stood at the top. So now, getting back, these Romans, they always have believed that these even numbers are not good. They are very unlucky numbers. So let us not have them. Let us have only either 29 days or 31 days, and 2 months were never there. After some time,
they were totally even, they even added 2 more months, and later they said that okay Baba, we have to have either 31 days or 30 days in a month. Now even that was a problem, because with 2 months to be given, added last month, see, 1 more month, as it was given previously to all the other months, 31 days were given in January. 31 days were allotted to January, and only the left out days, that is 29 days were left out of the total. How did they calculate? How did they calculate that they had only 29 days left out? Yes. Later, in the beginning, they never tried to count January and February. Later, when the calculation was done depending upon the phases of moon, that is depending upon the lunar moon positioning, it was very clear that yes, we need to have few more days also. So all the left out days, they were given to February. They were all given to February. 29 days were there. The rest had 31. Then what happened? See, August particularly, I told you, this was all related to the Romans. It was under the tenure of Julius Caesar. All of you might have heard about the name of Julius Caesar, who happens to be a dictator of Rome. So this Julius Caesar, that is why, he said, no, I should not have 30, I should have 31 days. So that particular month was named after Julius Caesar. And later, it was his uncle's name, Augustus Caesar. The later was Augustus Caesar, he was his uncle. And in respect of his uncle, he said, yes, even my uncle should be equally respected. And he too should have, previously it was only 30 days. He said, no, my uncle should be equally respected as I am being respected. So what to do now? Yes, February has got 29 days. Come on, remove that 1 more day and add it up to August. So both nephew and uncle, both have been respected equally. Both have got 31 days. But now the children wonder, after every 4 years, 1 day is added up. Because 1 day is taken out, people had some mercy. They showed some mercy on this poor February. And they said, okay, because we have taken out 1 day, after every 4 years, we will give 1 day extra day, and that day will be February 29. Now, how do we calculate? How do we calculate which month has got how many days? Now, if you observe, children, have you ever observed your wrist? Just above the wrist, you observe this part. Hope you are all very clear with this. You have some humps. Can you see the humps? If needed, I'll mark up with my pen so that it will be very clear to you. I'll put some green dots. Can you see here? These. It is very simple. Whether you have a calculator or not, whether you are carrying your cell phone or not with you, you can very clearly see this. These are the humps which you will be having. Every child, every human being, they will have this. How to remember which month has got how many days? So whichever place, starting with your index finger, this is your index finger, fold your index finger, you can see the hump here. So January is a bit high because of the hump, it looks high. So January will have 31 days. So January will have 31 days. Remember, January will have 31 days. And now you may not have to look at that. Just forget it. Alternatively, again, be careful. February will not have. February is a very, very peculiar month. Already I told you that we have taken away 29 days were there because of the Roman calendar. Even from that also 1 day was taken out. Because we had to respect uncle, Augustus Caesar. We had to respect Augustus. So this will not have 28 days. It had usually 28 days. So forget about this, will not count also. Then after Jan, what will you get? February. Then go to March directly. March will have 31 days. Alternate, again it is always alternate. Now April we have again alternate 30 days only. Then May we have again it will have only 31 days alternate. Remember it is always alternate. Now after May you have June. June we have 30 days and July already I told you we have alternate. If you go with alternate you will have 31 days. And July I told you about the story of Augustus. So Augustus also will have 31 days. So after 31, now these two are exceptional. These two are exceptional and all the rest of the months will have alternatively 30 and 31 crossed. September we have August, after that August you have September, you have 30 days. This month, that is October, we have 31 days. November you can check out, you will have only 30 days. And finally December you will have 31 days. So this again is a very simple trick where you can remember starting from your index finger, January down. There is a depression. All of you please fold your fist and look at the depressions and humps. You can very easily notice that there is a depression. So there are less number of days. Now again there is a hump. So March will have 31 days. Then again there is a depression. Then again there is a hump. So it is alternate. Now January, now observe carefully. January, February, March, April, May, June, July. Again you have to start from here. Or you can put this hand. Again you start from the index finger. Up to July you have counted. Then when you come to the index finger again, August again will have the hump. So August again will have 31 days. This is the simple trick that we have learned how to remember. Or if you can't remember all these, yes, come on, alternatively, except this February. We will talk about February now, right? Hope you have understood which month will have how many days. The exception is only about these uncle and nephew, right? Only these two are exceptions. Both will have, very next to each, they will have 31 days. Right. Now, what is a leap year? Now, one more question. Just now I was telling that, no. The month's distribution. Yeah. What is a leap year? Leap year, the story, as I told you, it went on like February. People took mercy on February. Yes, we will add up one more day. One extra day we are getting. So that extra day, whom to give? Let us give to February because already it has got less number of days. So generally, February will have 28 days. But now, in a leap year, we will have one extra day. One extra day will come to 29 days. February will have 29 days. How to know which year is leap year? Every 4 years, I don't remember which 4 years back it was leap year. Then how do I calculate now whether 2020 is a leap year or not? Very simple. Take any year, if you just divide it by 4. If you divide it by 4, if the number is divisible, if the number is divisible by 4, then you can say that this is a leap year. Yes, if you go back to the calendar, 2020 calendar would be available with everybody at home. So please go back to the calendar and please check for the day. February 29 would be present in your calendar. Now there is one more question. There is one more question. Is every year a leap year? Is every year a leap year? How? So, why? What is the concept? Why should we add one extra day? Was the question. Now, the total number of days, as I told you, approximately it was to complete one revolution geographically calculated based on the lunar based on the phases of the moon. The total number of days which came up was 365 days plus 0.24 days. Now 365, now every child of maybe elementary school, like class 3 or class 4, how many days are there in a year? The child would say 365 days. So only in a leap year we have one day extra. We give that one day extra because for the calculation convenience, what we have done, we are omitting this 0.24 day. It means again I'll come to this point later. Almost, not exactly, almost 1/4 day. Okay, so 1/4 day we are omitting, we are not counting in the calendar. So that 1/4, after every 4 years, so 1/4 this year, 1/4 next year, 1/4 the later year, after that again 1/4, total 4 1/4 will become, we will make out one full day. So that one full day, where are we calculating? We are calculating it to February, and thus we are giving 29 days in the month of February, which make it out as one complete leap year. Is that clear? That is how after every 4 years we have one leap year. Now one more question, ma'am. Yes, we should not forget that every century is not a leap year. Again, not every century is a leap year. Why every century is not a leap year? Again, the question comes. How to know whether a century is a leap year or not? Just now we used the thumb rule for calculating the leap year, that if a year is divisible by 4, then it is a leap year. For example, I will tell you now, maybe 1800, maybe 1800 is it divisible by 4? Let us see, dividing 4, 4 times 16, 2 would be left out, 4, 5 are 20, 4, 50. Exactly, it is divisible. But do you think it is a leap year? Sorry, you are mistaken. It is not a leap year. 1900. Let us see if 1900 is divisible by 4. Okay. Is 1900 divisible by 4? Now let us see. 4 jar 16. 3 would be left out, 4 sevens are 28, 2 would be left out, and after that 5 is 20. This year is divisible by 4. Is it divisible? Now this is not the parameter for calculating centuries. So the thumb rule that we have used for calculating the ordinary years cannot be applied while we are calculating for centuries. For example, when we have to calculate for centuries, we have to see that the number is divisible by 400. If a year is divisible by 400, only then it would be a leap year. Now getting back to our content, if only after 400 years we get a century as a leap year, if a century is divisible by 400, only then it is a leap year, like 1200, 1600, 2000, they were leap years. But 1800, is not a leap year. 1800 was not a leap year. You can, because now that your mobiles are available with you, you can go back to any number of days and years. You can please cross check that 1800 will not be a leap year, because it is not divisible by 400. That would be a problem. So though the number is divisible by 4, it is not a leap year. So only the confusion might arise in case of centuries. Then you can be very clear with dividing it, the number, by dividing the century by 400. Now hope you all have understood about the reason for an extra day in February, the reason for a less number of day in February, and the reason for getting a leap year after every 4 years. Now coming to the time zones. Now time zone, what is this time zone? Now it is already said, now this, for all practical purposes, what we have done, the earth is actually spherical in shape, but we, to understand it at a time, to have the view of the entire world at a time, we have cut it open and we have spread this map like this, and thus we have this map stretching from North America up to this corner after Australia. Right now here you can see some lines. Children, you can see here there are two lines. Now on this globe, this is exactly a replica of what you can see here. This is a globe. Because a sphere does not have any starting or ending point, what we have done, first we have drawn one line from North Pole to South Pole, and we have called it as prime meridian. Prime, I'm not speaking about prime number of mathematics, I'm speaking truly in English. Prime means very important. So here, this line is considered as very important line, and we have named it as 0 degrees. We have called it as 0 degrees. So first line is prime, so we call it as 0 degrees. So this would be your 0 degrees here, and here also it is termed as 0 degrees. Because it is PDF, it will not come. Right. Then exactly opposite to that. Now, what is this? This prime meridian, we also have called it as GMT. What is this GMT? Greenwich Mean Time. What is this Greenwich again? Why through London? There were all many questions. Why that prime meridian should pass only through London? Now, you have seen in the previous map that the... If you cut open the world, almost the London, the Greenwich passes through London. Here you have UK, where I have put a round. There you have UK. From in UK, there is a place through which approximately we have drawn a line which is called as Greenwich Mean Time. This is also called as prime meridian. Approximately it divides the world. And because it is spherical, now once again getting to the globe. Now this line, we have drawn one line, but Now the other side of that, exactly the opposite of that, we are taking it as international date line. Opposite to that, we take it as international date line. See, you can see here. Exactly opposite to that, you can see international date line. So when it is at 0 degree, the other side it would be exactly 180 degree. So this 180 degree we have adopted it as international date line. Again, I need to tell you, very important, that international date line is not a straight line like this. International date line is not a straight line. Now, why? There is a reason. If you get back to this, these are called as time zones. Every country, because each country will have a different children coming to the times. All of you must be wearing a fit band by now. Your parents, at least you or your parents or somebody in your house, must be wearing a fit band, because the age of using watches has gone with the coming of cell phone. No, previously people used to have different types of watches, clocks for finding out time. But now nobody even looks at the wall clock to get the time. We always look at our fit band. Just with our sight, you will be able to see the time. The time would be displayed. That much advancement has come in the technology. But in the previous days, people used to have a very, very traditional way of noting down time, like with the help of sunrise and sunset. So with the help of sunrise and sunset, even today in villages, people say sun rises at so-and-so time, then that would be considered as the local time. So in a particular place, supposing in Bangalore, if the sunrise is at 6:04 a.m. and the sunset is at 5:43 p.m., then that is only called as the local time. That is what is called as local time, because sun rises at different places at different times. Already in the very first beginning of the session we have seen. So if the time of a place is calculated based on the sunrise and sunset, then we call it as the local time of that place. But always this local time will not work out. Now with the modern society, when people are even traveling by aeroplanes, no, from different one country to another country they are traveling. They are not, you know, olden days people were only traveling through bullock carts, so it was okay for them to have the time. Now that we have the travel even through airways, from one country, maybe from this country to that country at the end, or maybe from here, New York to London, we have airways which carry the passengers. So for them, which time they should follow? Should they follow their local time, or should they follow this local time, local time at London? So all this was a big confusion. So finally it was decided that yes, we will have one standardized time, and that standardized time is called prime meridian. To avoid all the confusions, children, you will not believe, even during the time of the Britishers, that is till 1853, exactly till 1853, even India was using only local time, which was based on the sunrise and sunset of that particular place. But with the introduction of railways, when we had railways, trains which were running from Gujarat to that side of East Pakistan, from year to year, do you know how many longitudes are covered? Many longitudes are covered. For each longitude, there is already a difference of 4 minutes. So almost there is a difference of 2 hours in the time. 2 hours of difference. Then how will you take a flight? Is it according to their time, or is it according to the East Bengal time, or is it according to Gujarat time? So there was a confusion. So somewhere in 1853, after the railways started in India, what we did, we started adopting the IST. They said for India, we will have one IST. Not only our country, every country. Now, time zone. It means we have drawn, we have taken one band. You can see different alternative color bands. You can see the whole world is divided, which means that all the places falling in that particular color band, they follow one particular time zone. So, to avoid all the confusion, so all these countries, they follow one time zone. So, Brazil, now here for example, I come to Brazil. Now, this is not a straight line. Why they are not following a straight line? Because Brazil is one complete country, and one place of Brazil and another place of Brazil, they cannot have two different times. To avoid that, complete Brazil will have this time zone. That is why here the line has slightly deviated and again it has come back. Ours is really, ours is really exactly from here you can see this is a straight line. Only up to Sri Lanka, I will zoom up for you. Only up to Sri Lanka. Now, I have cleared everything. Now, I have drawn this line. Now you can see. Only Sri Lanka, this entire Indian part, they will follow our IST. But these places, we again, because India, these are Kolkata, West Bengal, now Nepal will not come. Nepal, Bhutan, they will not follow our IST. Because here, West Bengal, these regions belong to our country, we follow the same IST. But we do not follow this band. The pink color band which you can see is not followed. The whole India follows one, that is 82.5 degrees. Now, once again, what is this 82.5 degrees east? Now, we have adopted 82.5 degrees east as our IST. Now, this is the line that we have adopted. Though it passes through Nepal, Nepal is not following our IST. They have their own time zone. But only this country, complete Indian country, what is shaded like this, you can see, only Bangladesh also will not follow our time. They have their own time. We need to convert according to their time. Now, these 82.5 degrees, now I'll come back. This line as our standard line of India. We also call it as Indian Standard Time. We call it as IST, Indian Standard Time. And the time difference between the GMT, that is, I should write maybe this side. So GMT minus IST. If you deduct this time, now where is London? How to whether to deduct forward the to add? How do you know? Very simple logic we should not forget that. Now, this, where is London? Now, let us try to locate where is London. Here is London, here is India, right? So, here it is called 0 degrees and here we have called it as 82.5 degrees. So, automatically, very simple logic to understand that we are in the east of London. So, what we have to give? We have to write the notation as east. So, what is our standard longitude? 82.5 degrees east. I come to the point, why we have taken 82.5? Why neither 81? Why neither 83? Instead of that, why we have taken that point? I'll come to that later. Now, we have adopted this as our standard meridian. Having adopted that standard meridian, how do we know what is the time in London? So, first the sun rises here, correct? Because we are in the east. First, sun rises here. Slowly, slowly, sun rises here, very slowly. It means, children, remember we are all going back in your graph paper. You are all from x-axis, you are going to the y-axis. you are going into minus x. It is like going into minus x. So when you go from right to left, when you are going from right to left, it means we have to subtract. We have to subtract the time. Supposing here in India, now what is the time? Supposing it is 3 p.m. Then what we have to do? What would be the time at London now? Subtract 5 hours, 30 minutes. 5 hours, 30 minutes. If you subtract it, you will get it. Why we are subtracting? Because we are finding out the time of a place which is in the left to us. We are standing, we know where we are. We are in the east. Now we are moving from right to left. So we have to subtract. If we have to calculate the time of some other place, like maybe Korea, then what we have to do? We have to add the time. To find out the time of Korea, once again, remember, we need the longitude of Korea. Without longitude, we won't be able to find out the time. And approximately 1 hour calculation, if we convert this into 1 hour calculation, 15 degrees. Every 15 degree longitude, difference of time will be 1 hour. So even that also we can remember. Now getting back, why we have taken 82.5 degrees? Now, why we have taken 82.5 degrees, I'll tell you. From 0, 0 is here, I mean to say London or Greenwich. Greenwich is there. Where is India? India is somewhere here in the eastern side. Already in my first class of geography, I told you India is in the northeastern hemisphere. So here, India is somewhere in the east, and here we have adopted 82.5 degrees east. And how many degrees, how many longitudes are covered? Every 1 degree longitude, we have drawn one line. So if you calculate, supposing we say only 82, let us take a round figure. Why should we go with that half? Supposing we take a round figure, then with this 82 into, for how many for each degree longitude it is? 4 minutes. So 82 into 4, if you calculate that into minutes, you will get 8 into 4 are 32. So you will get 328 minutes. Again divided it by 60, because you need to convert it into hours. How much will you get? 6 ones are, again, 6 fives are 30. You will have to, 6 fours are 24. 6 fours are 24, then how much would be there? Another 4. So it would be 4 hours 44 minutes. No, again, 5, sorry, it would be 5 hours because we have to divide it by 10 also. So it would be 5 hours 44 minutes. What is this calculation of 44? We don't find comfortable. We are not comfortable with that 44 minutes. We are comfortable only with the quarters of the hours. It means we are comfortable because psychologically we will be comfortable to add or subtract 15 minutes, 30 minutes and 45 minutes. Or it is 1 hour, we can subtract it very easily. So what we have done, to make it a round figure, we have taken it as 82.5 degrees. You know that 82.5 degrees, actually in India it passes through Allahabad. There is a place called Mirzapur. Exactly, it passes through that place, Mirzapur. Allahabad already is a very important place. It's a place of Triveni Sangamam. We call it the confluence of Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati. So that point, children, in the map, if you look at the map, it may appear that, can you just zoom it up? Yes, see, when this is taken, okay, when this line is adopted as the standard meridian, it may appear. here that this ISD is somewhere in the corner of the map, but it is not so. Exactly also, if the distance here is calculated from here to here, the sharp distance, exact distance is taken and this part is adopted. That particular region, we have this region, we have taken it as the Indian standard time. So it passes through Allahabad, and in Allahabad it's a village called Mirzapur. Now getting back to this PowerPoint one.
PDF.
This one. Okay. Yes. Now let us try in this class, let us try to calculate the time. Now when it is noon, children, all of you know noon means it would be 12 o'clock noon in London. So London, it should be registered in our mind permanently that London, it is 0 degree. And when it is 12 noon at London, what is the time in New York? New York, see, for two places, if you have to calculate or compare the time for two places, you must and should have the longitude. When a longitude is not given in a question, so somewhere some trick or some logic is there. So suddenly a question appears, a cricket match is being played in Eden Gardens. Sorry, where is Eden Gardens? You are all fans of cricket, I know. Cricket, where is Eden Gardens? Eden Gardens is in Calcutta. So Calcutta, you should get it. Oh, Calcutta is in India. So what is the IST of India? So sometimes it would be very tricky, but the hint would be lying there only. No, we just need our presence of mind. Now, here, when it is noon at London, what is the time in New York whose longitude is approximately 75 degrees west? So because it is 75, we need not have to calculate into minutes to be converted into hours. Blindly, as already said, I said that you can remember that for every 15 degrees, there is 1 hour difference. So 15 degrees, total 15, 5 are 75. So you just 5 hours of difference. And now, is it plus or minus becomes a second question. Should it be plus or should it be minus? Now, always, when you have to calculate time, what you have to do? First, you have to draw three lines. You draw three lines. This is for standard. 0 degree is for standard. It will never change. Now, depending upon the place that they have given. Now, what is the place that they have given? New York. Where is New York? New York is in America. Where is America? This side is London, because zero is London. This side is America. Come on, draw another line. So is it in the east or west of zero? It is in the west of zero. Now, what is the time known here? He said that it is 12. Time is given there. And what is the longitude which is given? 75 degrees longitude. So 75 degrees of west. So we have found out that the time difference is 5 hours. It is very clear that the time difference is 5 hours. Now, very easy to tell whether we have to add or subtract, because we are moving it to minus of x-axis. Very simple graph paper. Just as I said in the first class, my first geography class, Earth's grid is like a graph paper. So minus x-axis, when you are going into minus x-axis, subtract 5 hours, you will get the time. So 12 noon it was given, that is 12 p.m. it was given. So you just subtract 5 hours, you will get the exact time, what it is at New York. This is how we have to calculate. Now, this is one example, what we have seen, how to calculate the time when we have a place which is on the western side. Now, there is one more place. Now, see here. There is one more question which we will take up to understand how to calculate the time when we are talking about a place which is in the right side. Again, the same logic applies. So, when it is noon again, in London, it is 10 p.m. in Sydney. Already we have given it is 10 p.m. in Sydney. So how many hours are difference? We will talk about that. Sydney in Australia,
And Danny, a person called Danny in London, he rings his friend in Sydney at 15:30 p.m. on Christmas Day. Christmas Day, what is Christmas Day? So again, sometimes there is, why I have specifically taken this Christmas Day? Because the date is fixed. It is always 25th of December. So on 25th December, Sydney, from Sydney, somebody has called at 3:30, 15:30, we have to convert it into regular time, it is 3:30 on Christmas Day. What is the time in Sydney? Now, when it is noon, now he has very cleverly asked a question. See here, he has only given the time difference. He has not given any longitude of Sydney. Longitude of Sydney is not given here. Then how to calculate? He has simplified your job. Say thanks that good, longitude is not given. Simplifying your job, he has given the time difference. How much is the time difference? 10 hours. You know, 12 p.m., 10 p.m., noon. Noon to 10 p.m. is 10 hours of difference. Already it is very clearly mentioned. So we need to note it down that the time difference is 10 hours. So from here, now I have added up those 10 hours. Where is Sydney? Again, the same question comes. What should I do? My logic remains the same. Always take this 0 degree as standard meridian. That remains the same. And now we are speaking from London. This is our prime place. And Sydney. Where is Sydney? Sydney is in Australia. Where is Australia? Australia is in the eastern side of London. So here is Sydney. So what you have to do, 10 hours, we know the 10 hours of difference. We know that the time is 10 hours difference. So what we have to do now, we have to add up, because we are going to the right. It is the plus of the x-axis, the positive side of the x-axis. Children, hope you all have understood very simply. The standard way is first to draw the prime meridian, then depending upon the position of the place with reference to prime meridian, you have to write, draw another line or this side or that side, and then you have to find out the time difference. Based on the right side, if it is the right side, we have to add up the time. If it is the left side, we have to subtract the time. This is how time can be calculated for different places at different times. Now, check once again. So this is a task for you where you all will have to calculate, all the viewers. I expect you to calculate this because our Honorable Prime Minister Modi, who would be going, you know, all know 24th October is going to be the formation of UNO Day. And that day, our Prime Minister is going there all the way to New York. Headquarters, again, it is not mentioned here. Only, they have given only as headquarters. Where is the headquarters? Again, your history comes here. So, headquarters of UNO is in New York. They are good. Thank God they have given this. So, the New York, what is the longitude of New York? 75 degrees west. Sharp at 9 o'clock, because there the office timing sharp 9 o'clock. But what would be the time here? So, please calculate the time, because we all have to watch. Because it is our Indian Prime Minister, we would be very enthusiastically waiting for his speech, to listen to his speech. So please do the calculation for this. So with this, as on now, we will end the session for today with the task being assigned to you. I hope all of you have understood everything about your time, the duration of days and night, why there is extra day in February, and why the number of days are very less in February, what is a leap year, how every century is not a leap year, why only after 400 years we have a leap year once again. So all these, your doubts might have been cleared. Thank you very much, Smart C.
Thanks a lot, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Excellent, excellent class. A very good amalgamation of geography and mathematics. Rare thing to watch how geography and mathematics has been integrated so well. I think all of us were glued to
Yes, that is what is integrated approach. Like all the subjects are how closely related. The only thing is it depends upon teacher how she.
For our convenience, we might have divided, but everything is one.
Exactly. Yes. So I'm very sure that all of our viewers must be in awe of the class. Right from how the day has got 24 hours to how just 15 degrees longitude make it as 1 hour difference, how we have to minus and how we have to plus when we are moving from one place to another, the time. I think it is all excellently well explained. So our viewers, I am sure that you have enjoyed this class thoroughly and understood each word madam has explained to us. So as the task is given, kindly complete that task and put it in our comment box. In our next class, we'll be taking up your answers and discuss about those comments, where we went wrong or where we have excelled. So complete the task and put it in our comment box. Thanks a lot, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you once again.
Thank you. Yes, you are stay connected with us and eagerly we will be waiting for your answer on the task given in the comment box so we can discuss on that in the next class. Till then, stay connected, stay safe.